Question one has passed.
It was an outcome for which Beth Robinson had prepared herself, but it stung just the same.
We obviously in Vermont were invested in it.
The chair of the Vermont Freedom to Marry Action Committee had been deeply involved in the effort to protect gay marriage in Maine, encouraging advocates in her state to help those in another. But ultimately Tuesday, they lost the fight, with 53% of Mainers voting to repeal a state law that legalized same-sex marriage last spring. It was a sad day for advocates in Vermont, who just 2 months ago...
You mean okay.
Celebrated the state's first same-sex marriages when a new law went into effect.
We're engaged in a long-term civil rights movement, and you're going to have two steps forward and one step back. We've had a lot of steps forward this year. This was a setback.
Vermont was the first state to legalize same-sex marriage through a legislative vote. Maine would have been the first to do so through a popular vote. The fact that it wasn't, traditional marriage advocates say, reaffirms that the general public does not want this change.
31 states have said at the ballot box, no to same-sex marriage.
Craig Benson of LetVermontVote.org has been leading a charge to preserve traditional marriage for the past decade. The results in Maine, he says, bolster his efforts, though he adds a gay marriage referendum in Vermont is unlikely until a new legislature is voted in.
If we see a lot of changeover, we then begin to work towards whatever the next step would be.
That's where his focus will be going forward, he says, on cleaning house, as he puts it, in Vermont's heavily Democratic House and Senate. And he does expect to see a significant political shift next year. But even if the tides change, Beth Robinson doesn't think same-sex marriage will be up for debate again.
I suggest that, 3 years from now or 5 years from now, Vermonters are going to go back and revisit this. I don't see that happening.
As more time passes, she believes more people will see they have little issue with this issue at all. Anya Hunneke, News Channel 5.